Hello and welcome to another edition of Fermanagh GAA TV. Tonight we're coming from the excellent surroundings of the Enniskillen Hotel here, and with the start of this Sunday's McKenna Cup, where Fermanagh faced Queen's University of Belfast, before Derry come calling the Enniskillen once again the following Sunday, and then on Wednesday, January 14th, it's a trip down to Ballybuffet to meet up with former Fermanagh great Rory Gallagher's Donegal. Tonight we're coming here with this man on my left hand side, he needs no introduction. It's former Down Double All-Ireland winning manager, Pete McGrath, who's travelled a bit tonight. Thanks very much for coming tonight, Pete. To my right-hand side here is the once again Fermanagh senior football captain and co-footballer, Eoin Donnelly. Cheers for coming, Eoin. Thank you, now. Pete, we'll start with yourself. Into your second season now as Fermanagh manager, do you maybe feel you're more comfortable in the role this year, that you've got to know the players and a better pre-season, I suppose?
Yes, I think this time last year, we were all chasing our tails to a certain extent. We were trying to get a squad together. Our pre-season training had been belated because of the lateness of the appointment, and all the players were virtually complete strangers to me. So it took quite a while to get everything bedded in, and you could even say that as the season went on, there were, you know, bedding in problems and there were issues, and I mean, it took me a while to get a handle on the players and on their temperaments and on their ability and what they could do and what our best possible team might even look like. But this year we've had time over the summer, we've looked at a lot of club football, we've held trials and we got training started nice and early, and I feel certainly there's a lot more stability. Brian Tracy has joined the management team, he's been a big, big asset. So I think that we're in a much healthier position this year to take the campaign forward than we were this time last year.
Yeah, there's been good challenge games too, again the likes of Leitrim and Monaghan. Happy enough with the way the players are progressing?
Yes, the training has been very, very good, very good quality training. The players have responded excellently to the demands that have been made of them. And both challenge matches, although played in difficult conditions, were very enlightening for myself and indeed for the players as well, because players have to get a handle on their own performances. And the McKenna Cup now starting on Sunday, the three guaranteed matches in that competition will most certainly push the team forward and give us all a better idea of exactly where we stand in preparation for the National League.
Cheers for that. Eoin, I suppose any young fella growing up, yourself included, playing for Coe, you're now captain of Fermanagh senior football team. It must be a great honour to yourself and your family.
Yeah, very proud. I think when you're young, you probably aspire to get to play for your senior club team, and then looking ahead of that, trying to get towards your county team. And you know, it was never really something that I thought when I was younger that I would get the captain of my county. So you know, once I got there and was given the honour, I'm very proud to lead Fermanagh out.
Is it true that you maybe have an uncle that maybe captain Fermanagh too? Did a raid somewhere?
My uncle John Donnelly would have played for Fermanagh. I think he retired in 1981. They got to the Ulster final in 82.
Right.
So yeah, John would have, he would have played a lot of football and probably sort of was in the family as
such. Was. And just in your own playing front, I know it's been well documented you went for the hand injury just before Christmas. Are you seeing maybe game time soon coming up?
Hopeful. Got the sort of good positive from feedback from the consultant and that, so things are moving forward and trying to get back into full training.
Right.
Trying to get some game time. Just depending on obviously when Pete can give me some game time, and trying to get up to full fitness before the league starts.
Yeah, we all wish you well in that comeback front. Pete, moving on, I've seen the McKenna Cup panel announced 26 players. At the moment, there's quite a few university players out there too, such as the Collins, Tiernan, and Daly. When then hopefully players come back for the, of course, January 31st for the Louth game, will we see players maybe cut from a grand total, or are you going to be hoping to keep a full panel?
No, it would be our intention to keep the current squad in place in its totality. Because last year, as we went towards championship, because of injuries and people dropping out of the squad, we were left with a panel of 28, which was too small in terms of for training purposes and for having meaningful football at training. So one of the objectives we had this year, when we were going through trials and digging into the players that were in the county, we were determined to create a panel of 35-36.
Okay.
And I think at the moment that is roughly the figure that we've got. So it would be my intention to hopefully keep all the players on board, and as a consequence of that, have a lot of competition for places within the squad.
And just on the current squad, it's great to see players such as, you know, your Kieran Flaherty's, your Daniel Cage, your Michael Jones just coming back into the squad. One player in particular that's probably been mentioned quite a bit in the papers, Seamus Quigley. He's top scorer in the Fermanagh Championship for the past two seasons. Is there any opportunity that man will be playing in 2015 for Fermanagh?
No.
Right. Well, moving on to yourself. Last season was probably disappointing overall, 3 wins in 12 games for Fermanagh. We're probably missing experienced players now, such as your Barry Owens, as your Eoin McGuire's. Has the younger players such as Eoin McManus, James Allen, them younger players come in and impressed you?
I think they have. I've had to sort of stand on the sidelines and watch a lot of the training and the football, and the younger lads that have come in, there's a lot more apart from Eoin and James.
Yeah.
And putting in big efforts in training and pushing the whole thing on. I heard recently somebody saying about, you know, the sort of the encouragement doesn't have to always come from the top, it can come from the younger lads coming up, and you can kind of see that in the training as well, and these lads are sort of fitted in well to training, and they're going well in the matches to date. So I think now that when they get the opportunity to get into the team, they look like they're sort of part of the furniture, and they're able to hold their own, definitely.
I know it's the wrong way down the line, but we've allowed come down a skill, and then we travelled to Sligo in early February. Division 3 is looking very tough this year with the likes of Clare and Tipperary coming up and Armagh and Louth coming down. You know, can you see us maybe hopefully getting promotion long term?
That'd be very positive, yeah. Looking ahead to 2015, you know, we'd be hoping that anything that we come up against in the league, you know, they're going to pose their own problems, but whenever they look at us, you know, we're going to have plenty of firepower and plenty of players that can cause them damage. So
yeah,
I'd be very positive that Fermanagh can do very well in Division 3 next year.
Certainly hope so. Pete, going back to Sunday's encounter with Queens, we do know the Shea Cullen of Bell and Eck playing for them. Do you know maybe much more about the university team at all?
Very, very little. I'm not sure what the composition of their panel is. Obviously they will have players from other counties, and Queens will be well organised. James McCartan manages them, and they'll be taking mechanical very seriously, because Sigerson to them isn't that terribly far away. And you know, yeah, there'll be a threat to us on Sunday afternoon, but it'll be a good game, and these are the games that we want. I mean, the Queen's game, the Derry game, the Donegal game, I mean, it's up to us to really get as much out of these games as we possibly can. We said to the players earlier in the season that every game we play this year, we want to go out to perform and to win. Let's not say it's just the Mechanic Cup. It's a competition, it's competitive football, and we have to set the target that we want to win the 3 matches in our section and qualify for the semi-final. And that is the mentality that we've taken to Sunday's game and beyond Sunday's game.
I do know the Queen said of 8 down players named in the panel, so hopefully they'll take it easy on Sunday on us. As well, Pete, just on the old Fermanagh players, the likes of John Woods, Tomás Corrigan's travelling. Will you hopefully they'll be back in action sooner rather than later for Fermanagh?
Well, I spoke to John a few days ago, and he still is unavailable. I'd be hopeful maybe that in the very, very early spring, that John's situation may have eased and that will allow him to come back. He's very keen to come back, but it's just physically impossible given the demands that are on his time at the moment. Tomás Corrigan, I think, is already back from his travels, and I think hopefully Tomás will see some time in the Mechanic Cup. Not Sunday, but hopefully in the 2 matches beyond Sunday.
Great to hear. Well, maybe just moving on to club matters, just yourself with Coe. You'll find yourselves in 2015 a newly formed Fermanagh Club Junior Championship. Probably a realistic chance of yourselves lifting silverware and hopefully competing in the Ulster Club competition then, later on.
Yeah, Coe is a sort of strong tradition. And the Ulster Club Junior Championship, we beat Ahar in Brewster Park probably at the start of the sort of the early 2000s, and that was sort of the start of a run that we had a few years doing well in the Ulster Club Junior Championship. So it'd be good for our club to get into the Ulster Club, but you know, it's going to be very competitive section in the junior championship teams that are there. Realistic aim last year was to win the intermediate. We didn't do that, so this year we're going to start it again, and we'll be aiming to win the junior championship. So, but the other three teams in there as well are going to have the same mentality.
There's certainly big changes for Fermanagh Club football overall, hopefully for the good. Pete, we draw to a close here, just for yourself, realistically for all Fermanagh supporters out there, what would your maybe aspirations and expectations be for the 2015 season for Fermanagh?
Well, when I took over the job last year, I said that my key objective was to get the best possible panel on the field, training and playing for Fermanagh. And I said, however far that takes us then, we'll see. Having gone through that year and having got to know the players and know what's available in the county, and having seen the level of commitment that we're really getting from the players and the quality of player that's there, we are in three competitions. We're in the McKenna Cup starting on Sunday, we're in Division 3 of the National League, and we're in the Ulster Championship. And we are capable of performing to the level that would put us into a position where we could win those three competitions. Sometimes the only thing that holds you back is yourself. And we have to believe, we have to want, we have to be prepared to make the sacrifices, and the players are doing all of those things. So we have to be confident in our own ability and look around us and say, well, look, why should we, in our own minds, think that we are inferior to any team out there? Any team out there. I'm not suggesting that we could beat Dublin, but Dublin aren't in Division 3, and Dublin aren't lost the championship. But the teams that we're going to be up against on any given day, we're capable of beating any of them. And it's just a question of us all believing that, working towards those objectives, and when those days come, that we deliver. So that's the mindset that I have going forward into 2015.
Well, we all certainly can't wait for that. But first of all, I'd like to say a massive thank you to Eoin and Pete, a massive thank you to yourself for coming on tonight. That's all we have time for tonight, folks. I want to thank you again to Enniskillen Hotel. A happy new year, and hopefully see you all on Sunday in Brewster Park. Thank you very much.